Queens and kings, welcome back to my channel. Today, I will be drawing your portrait, drawing that beautiful face of yours, or should I say, soul of yours. In my journal / art book, here's my butterfly I drew quite a while ago now. I've had this book for almost 13 years and I still haven't filled it. I'm one of those people that only draws and writes when they're inspired. So this is my warrior of the moon drawing. It's kind of like a bow and arrow, but it's supposed to be a tattoo. Thank goodness I didn't get that done. I have few tattoos and I'm seriously considering to remove them all. Well, almost all. This one came to me in a dream. I had a dream. Walking through this giant room of aquariums, but like the aquariums were 20 feet high, and all of a sudden this fish just swims by and its tail is like all patterns and all colors, and it just takes over the tank. So when I woke up, I wanted to draw it, and that's how it came up. Oh, here's my mermaid. She's got a big tail. My mermaids of preference have to have big tails. I don't know why, I just love it. So, that's my mermaid. Was also supposed to be a tattoo. I wanted a big sleeve. And this was when I was like 22, 23. I'm just really grateful that I didn't do it. And it gets to live in my book. And I get to see it whenever I want. Here's a little panda from behind. I called it Lil Floof. And it's just a panda just being a little floof. Being his cute little self. Probably eating some bamboo. And this one is my bat. told that the badger was a spirit animal that was helping me to develop my psychic, intuitive skills. So it says, "Thank you for helping me connect, receive, and interpret messages from the animals." So I drew the badger. I actually love the badger. I don't know if anyone remembers the badger video that came out a while ago. It's like, honey badger, don't give a shit. It's a really good video. Honey badgers will eat anything and fight anyone. They don't care. You should watch that video if you haven't. I might link it under this video. And this is my orca sea wolf, as I've seen them be called. The orca has come to me in various dreams, very symbolic. So I've grown a very beautiful connection with orcas, and I hope one day I get to swim with them. As much as that terrifies me, it's one of my dreams to do. So I wanted to show you one more thing before I start to draw you. So in my book, I like to write and draw. I like to keep inspirational quotes, things that help remind me to stay on the right path. So I'll show you. One of the pages. So I like to draw, I like to write the quote, and then I like to draw little doodles. So we've all got both light and dark inside us. What matters is the part we choose to act on. To love something is to give it room enough to grow. And I drew a little plant growing in there, which I thought was really nice. Let nature be your teacher. I love this one because I wrote this like 10 years ago, and I still, this one, I always go out to the forest to get peace, harmony within myself, I get grounded. I've learned so much, just so much about myself just by being out there. So nothing that happens is ever forgotten, even if you can't remember. So sometimes when I can't remember something, and when I'm taking my walk, my daily walk with my dog, I set an intention for anything that has been forgotten by me to come back to me. Anything that I need to keep going on my path, anything that I need to remember, to please come back to me. And by the end of the day, I have these light bulb moments where I'm like, oh yeah, I forgot about that. And then I keep it a little bit closer to me so that it's not as easily forgotten. And I'm talking about like a thought that I had, or a realization, something with meaning. This one, learn what is to be taken seriously and laugh at the rest. I like that one. And you have two choices: to control your mind or to let it control you. So that's just a little bit of what's in here. But let's get to your drawing. Okay. So we have my tools here. Eraser and some colors. So I need you to stay as still as you can for me and just keep shining that beautiful light, and I will draw you just as you are. Okay. So, I don't have very good eyesight. I can't see very well from far away. So if you see me, like, squinting, it's because I can't see and I'm trying to focus my lenses. Or I have to get, like, really close to the page so I can see the detail of what I'm doing. I need glasses, like, all the time. I should wear them all the time because I can't see detail. But I don't want to, because I can get by just fine. I don't want to be dependent on glasses, but I've always had bad eyes. My grandma had astigmatism, and I think I inherited it because I have astigmatism in both my eyes, but one of my eyes is worse. stay still, okay? I'm getting a really crucial part. I want to get it right. You're so pretty. Even my king's out there, you're so pretty. My kings and my queens. You guys are just so important. I'm just gonna take this time to tell you how important you are and how special and how proud you should be of yourself for getting this far. And I hope my portrait of you reminds you of that truth and your value and how important you are. Every single one of you is so important. You're a drop in the ocean. And that is what makes up the ocean. So, you do have influence. You do. I hope you're using it for your highest good. Because when you do that, you do it for the highest good of all of us. So, thank you. And I also want to set the intention that once you see the portrait that I'm drawing of you, once you see it, I hope it inspires you to shine, to be your authentic self, unapologetically. Because I think the world needs more authenticity. And we just need to step out of our comfort zones and be ourselves. And that way we influence the world positively, because it's genuine. You're a very good model. Thank you for cooperating. Okay, I think I'm ready for the colors. So, I like to outline my drawings because it always makes them pop. Blue. Gonna like this. I've only had my portrait drawn live once. It was like a caricature drawing. Some of those are so brutal, the ones I've seen online. The artist just like over exaggerates features of people so they look it's brutal but funny. We have to laugh, right? Learn what is to be taken serious and laugh at the rest. That's the guidance. Because if we spend too much time getting offended and triggered, it's just using up our energy and our time. And the longer you sit with it, the more it just weighs on you and it feels heavy. I just think there's better things to be focused on. But I've learned more recently that getting triggered is a good thing because it shows you what you need to work on in yourself. So whenever you get triggered, it's the best opportunity to stop and reflect. So, why am I getting offended? What just happened? Just analyzing the situation and kind of watching it from an outside perspective. So you're not involved, I guess. Like you're watching a movie and see how you feel after that. Or see what you can find out, being on the outside like that. I remember once, I don't even remember what we were arguing about. I think I was with an ex and we were arguing. I think it was right before we broke up. But anyway, we were arguing and it was so serious. And all of a sudden, I look at him and I'm like, or something, and then I look away and I start smiling and laughing to myself because, I mean, I didn't show him that I was smiling and laughing, but it was like I knew deep down that it was silly. Like, it was just drama. And it wasn't gonna work out with him anyway, so what's the point, right? But anyway, I found that really funny and surprising because I was in the relationship, like, it was serious. It was a year relationship, a year long, one of my longest at that time. So I should have been taking it seriously, right? And then I just laugh. I still think about it and it makes me laugh. Like, that's when you know what is real and what isn't for you, when you can just perspectively step out of the situation and see it for what it is. If it's petty, it's interesting. I love human psychology. It's so interesting to me. Why people act the way they do, why I act the way I do. I am an analyzer and an observer. I like to sit back and look and see what everyone's doing and how they're doing it. You're looking good. I really like how this is turning out. And I haven't drawn anything for a while, so this is nice. Drawing and coloring is a really good way to turn your mind off and just be. Just enjoy the moment. I like to have music on when I do this type of stuff. I love music. I don't know how to play any instruments, but I love music. If I hear a song that just gets me, good rhythm, good lyrics, good melody, I have to have that song. I have to know who it's by, what's it called, and then I put it in my library. And then I listen to it. Recently, I've been playlisting a lot, so I've made about 10 different playlists, and there's like upbeat mix, there's chill, feel good mix, there's beat rock, chill rock, there's upbeat folk, soul rock, chill folk, soul rock. So basically I have upbeat and chill playlists, my two moods. I like to incorporate the music that I collect into my shorts on YouTube and my stories and posts on Instagram. So if you're interested and curious about my music selection, I invite you to look at my Instagram and my video, my shorts on YouTube. There are some really good tunes on there. And they're just little clips too, because shorts aren't very long and stories aren't very long. But I like that because I can pick out a section of the song that I really like, and it's usually the intro or the outro or like the middle where the bridge, where there's no lyrics, there's no singing, when the song takes a break in the middle. If you please. I have a song stuck in my head that I recently discovered. Maybe it's me. Maybe it's me. I'm not unlucky. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's me. clip. I'm gonna link it so you can hear it. Because I don't do it justice. But it's a catchy song. And it will make you dance if you like to dance. I hope you like to dance. Dancing is a great way to get your blood pumping, get energy moving in your body and releasing it. So if you feel like if you feel really overwhelmed, just start jumping up and down and dancing. It's like movement helps to get the energy unstuck. And it's a distraction too, because when you, if you're anxious or something, and then you're anxious about something you can't control, and then you start moving around, you get distracted, and then your energy and your thoughts, your mind isn't focused on that anymore. So the anxiety falls away, goes away. But that doesn't mean that it's healed, it just means that it's been moved. It's moving. But yeah, it's, I mean, you could heal a little bit of it, maybe, depending on the gravity of it. If it's like a childhood trauma, like a childhood wound, then it might take a little bit more than that. But it's really freeing, and I hope you like to dance. I love dancing. I have midnight dance parties in my room. My headphones on all the time. Just movement in general is just so good for you. So I'm just adding some last details to your portrait. I'm almost done. You are just gorgeous. Okay, you have to hear that song. And you're just like, what is she talking about? A masterpiece. You have been very patient. Thank you very much. in that love symmetry, so one side has to match, kind of match the other side. No, you look great, I promise. I'm done. Are you ready? Okay. Ta-da! You are a beautifully bright, sparkly diamond. Look how you shine. I think I did a really good job to capture your true self. You are a diamond. All of you. Oh, something's popping over here. All my kings and queens, all of you are big. Beautiful, sparkly diamonds. And I see that in you. And I'm proud of you for it, for shining and being a beacon for others. So, I hope you like it. I think you look beautiful, gorgeous. Do you want to see what popped out? It's my aerial cup wrap thing that came out of my cup. It used to be a cup, and now it's this piece of film that I keep. But I just love her tail. The detail of it. It's so pretty. And I got this at Hot Topic. Always get my mermaid stuff. Hot Topic. My Ariel stuff. I'm so glad that you hung out with me and got your portrait drawn. I hope you liked it. I hope you know how beautiful you are, and how important you are. Thanks for being here, kings and queens, queens and kings. Sending love always. Eloise.